Hi and welcome to today's tutorial on photo editing in Photoshop, where we will learn how to add vibrancy, contrast and other effects using just two tools. Let's have a look at this sample photograph that could use some improvement as it currently lacks the dynamic range and contrast, which are two key ingredients for a great photograph. As you can see, before photo looks a bit dull and flat. However, we are going to make it pop in just few easy steps. So don't worry, with the help of two tools, we will turn this lackluster image into a stunning. So let's get started. Once you have opened your photo, it's important to select the background layer by clicking on it. Next step is to duplicate the layer, which you can do easily by pressing Ctrl or Command plus J. This creates a new layer above the background layer that you can work with. Now that you have two layers, you can right click on the new layer and select Convert to Smart Object from the drop down menu. This is an important step because it allows you to make non-destructive edits to your photo. Double clicking on the thumbnail of layer 1 will open up a new window with the duplicated layer. This is where we will start to bring the photo to life. The next step is to go to Image Adjustments and select HDR Toning. If you are prompted to make changes, just hit Yes. Now you can play with the different settings to your liking. The radius settings controls the range of pixels that will be adjusted. The strength setting controls the intensity of the effect. The tone settings controls the brightness and contrast of the image. And detail settings controls the sharpness and clarity of the image. To make the image look even better, we will make one small tweak by selecting the smooth edges option before clicking OK. This option can help to reduce any artifacts or haloing that may be visible around the edges of the photo. By using this option, we can ensure that the final result looks as smooth and natural as possible. Overall, the HDR toning tool is a powerful way to add vibrancy and depth to your photos. With a little bit of experimentation, you can create stunning, eye-catching images that will really stand out. After you have made the desired changes to the HDR toning effect, you need to save the changes. Once the file is saved, go back to the original document to see the changes. You will notice that the effect has been updated and applied to the image. One of the greatest advantages of using HDR toning is that it is non-destructive. This means that the effect is applied to its own layer, which can be easily adjusted or removed without affecting the original image. Now you can lower the opacity of the layer by 40% or any other value depending on your preference. HDR toning allows us to create a more dynamic photo, which is essential for an eye-catching image. It adds contrast, color vibrancy and a greater range of tonal values, making the photo more visually appealing. When editing a photo, replacing the sky can be a great way to add dynamic effect to the image. To achieve this in Photoshop, select the background layer and go to Edit, select Sky Replacement. You will see a new dialog box pop up with a preview of the image and several options to select from. In this example, we want to change the foreground lighting to make it look brighter. You can use any sky from the sky library or upload your own sky as well. Once you have selected your desired sky, click OK to apply the changes. Now we want to make sure that the sky replacement folder is moved to the top of the layers panel. This will ensure that any subsequent filters or adjustments are applied to the entire image, including the sky. Now with the layer sky selected, go to Filter and add Lens Blur. Adjust the radius to your liking to blur the sky. In this example, the radius is set to around 45, but you can experiment with different values to achieve the desired effect. Once you are satisfied, click OK to apply the filter. These steps help to create a more dynamic and professional looking photo by replacing the sky and adding depth of field with the lens blur. Finally, to give the photo a cinematic look, I suggest using the color lookup option. To blend the colors, select the layer mask and add apply image. By default, the colors blend with the highlights of the image. But if you want to blend with the shadows, choose invert option. This will create a more balanced look in the image. After adding the color lookup, I recommend checking the layer mask and ensure that the sky has no white areas. Any white area should be removed to create a more natural look. That's it. Here is the before and after. The after photo have more vibrancy, contrast and dynamic range than the original photo and look more eye-catching and professional. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful and learned something new. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like and consider sharing it with your friends or on social media. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notification bell so you don't miss out any future tutorials or updates. Thanks again for tuning in, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.